Okay, guys, today we are going to start the session, and the topic of today's session is constructor. So what do you mean by constructor? First of all, I'm just going to discuss this thing. Just like in a normal life, few people have seen what constructor are doing, what they do with the constructors. They just construct your house, they design it, they make it, and they construct it. Similarly, and in programming also, the constructor is again going is again used, you know, for the same purpose. What we do, they help us while we are designing, while we are creating any object of a class. They help us like to allocate a memory to those objects, and whatever data member and member function of the classes or which object you have created, they help you to give values, to assign values or to assign memories to those data members through which you have created an object, and it is going to be helpful for you. Because you know what is happening, just like in a real life, if you are taking any plot, if you are taking any house, if you are not initializing, if you are not putting up anything in it, anybody can come and start existing there. You know. So similarly, in a program also, in Java also, while you are creating any variable like A, B, or C, and if you are not giving any value to it, like A, B, or C, if you are not giving any value to it, what is going to happen? Like any garbage value can come up and start existing there. And what is the drawback? Like whatever calculation you are going to do in future, all these garbage value is going to destroy your all calculations, whatever you are going to keep in those boxes. So here I'm just going to explain you like what the constructors they are going to do. Like for example, if you are creating an object of some class, and the class data member, inside data member you have an A and you have a B. For example, this is A and this you have a B, and the type of both the of both the variable is integer. Both the constructor they are doing, they run automatically and they initialize your data member. Now how they initialize and in what all the cases they are initialized. See, if you guys are not designing your own calculator, then Java, your constructor, then Java has its own constructor. Again, I'm going to repeat myself, if you guys are not designing a constructor, it is not mandatory. Java has its own constructor. It is going to run automatically by its own, and it is going to, it is going to initialize your variable with some default value. Like if you have an integer, the integer will be initialized with zero. If you have any other data type, that will be initialized, you know, with some other value. So it is going to work like this. So if you have an integer, integer will be initialized with zero. If you have a float, that will be initialized with 0.0. If you have a double, that is again going to be initialized with 0.0. And if you have a long, will be initialized with zero. So if it will be happening like this, the string will be spaces, character with a space, and boolean with false. So this is a constructor, guys. If you are not initializing, Java has its own constructor which is going to run, which will initialize you all data members values by its own. But if you want to design your own constructor, you can also design your own constructor. You can also initialize your data member, your variable, the value which you want. So basically, we are going to deal in this session today with three different types of constructor. The first constructor, the first type is default constructor. I'm just going to write the pointers here. First, we are going to deal with a default constructor. Second, we are going to work with parameterized constructors. So the first type of constructor is default constructor. The second type of constructor is parameterized constructor. And the third type of constructor is copy constructor. So we are going to deal with all these things, all these three different types of constructor. So let's jump to the coding window. I'm just going to explain you how you can design your own constructor. Simply, I'm giving a very similar name to my class, that is cons, and I got my class. I'm just going to go back to my class. I'm deleting entirely everything. I'm just writing here class. Quickly, I just write here cons. I'm coming back to my class and I'm going to start writing a constructor. But guys, few things you just need to know. What is constructor? Basically, you know, constructor name and the class name are always similar. Why it is similar? Because the moment you create an object of your class, you always write the name of your class and then you write the name of the object. So your constructor is just looking, it looks like a function, guys, but it's not a function. Even it is known as a special function. Why it is known as a special function? Because its name and the class name are always similar. Then how it will be called? The question is how it will be called. So when I create the object of my class in public static void main, because its name is same as my class, it will get an indication and it will be called and the values will get initialized automatically. First of all, the difference, the main difference is it looks like a normal function, but it's a special function and its name and the class name are always same. So I'm just going to create here a few data types first of all, which we have already done. This is my class and I'm just creating, you know, three data types. I'm just writing an A, comma, B, comma, C, the three data types I have created here. And now I'm going to write the name of the constructor. See, I've already told you my class name is similarly to my constructor name. It means my constructor name is always like class name. So I'm just writing here const. I'm opening parenthesis. I'm come to my next line. One more thing, guys, your constructors are public and they don't return any value. You always need to remember this thing. Constructors are always public and they don't return any value. So what I'm going to do is directly I'm writing the name of my class. I'm coming into it and I start initializing my value. I've already told you that the integer will be initialized with zero. So I'm having ABCs of type integer. So I'm simply going to initialize with zero. This is default constructor, guys, because I'm initializing here the variables with the default value. So this is a very simple function. You can see it looks like a function only, but only the thing is that I'm not returning any value from it. The name is similar to the class. I've just initialized all my variables with a default value. Now let's come to the public static void main and start creating object of a class. I'm simply writing here public static void main and this is my space. I'm just writing a public static void main and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create object of my class. So I simply write here const and write here obj is equal to new and I write here const. I put round bracket, I come to my next class, next line. So basically what is const, guys? Const is the name of my class. So the moment I write here const obj, so the object of, you know, the object will be created of type const. And the moment I'm writing here new, so new is a keyword in itself, which is going to ask a space from operating system so that my obj will be initialized in a memory. My obj will get some space in a memory and it starts existing there so that I can use it. Because once I create an object of my class, I'll be able to call all my functions. So this is very important. So the moment I'm writing here const, the name of my class, I'm writing here obj is equal to, I write here new. After new, I'm writing here again the name of my class. So it means that my obj will be created in the memory and I'm going to get the same space of type const for my obj object. So the moment you write here, guys, new const, the moment you write here new const and you leave here, you know, empty parenthesis, the control is going to search. The control start with that searching where your const is defined, So the moment is the moment your control is getting a const with empty parentheses, it means that this is the same constructor which you want to call. Your control will go inside and it will initialize your A with zero, B with zero, and C with zero. Now, guys, such kind of constructors are known as default constructor. Why they are known as default constructor? Because here you are initializing your data members with a default value. With a default value, integer default value is zero, float is 0.0, double is 0.0, character is space, and string is again space. Boolean is false. So now once my constructor is called, how to check whether the same values are initialized into A, B, and C, what I have initialized. So for this, I'm simply going to design here one display function. I'm writing here get display. This is my function. And I'm going to display here the value of ABC. Simply, I'm coming in this function and I'm writing here system.out. I'm writing here system.out.println. I'm opening parentheses and I'm simply writing here A. I'm putting here dash, coming out of it. And I'm writing here B. And plus, I'm putting here B. I'm writing in double inverted comma C and this is my C. So I'll get to know the value of A, I'll get to know the value of B, I'll get to know the value of C once I call this function. So once my constructor is called, I've created the object of my class. Now my second responsibility is I just need to check whether my values are initialized or not. Now we know the name of the function. This getDisplay is a function, it is not a constructor. This is the name of the function getDisplay, which I can call with the help of some object. So I'm just going to create an object of my class, which I've already created. You can see I've already created an object of my class obj. So I simply come up here and I write here obj dot. I come to the end. I'm putting here parenthesis. I put semicolon. So I'll get to know the values what I've initialized. I'll get to know. I'm just putting here a semicolon. I compile it once again. I go back to my dashboard. I right click and I click on main, void main. Now you will get to know the output. You can see my A is 0, my B is 0, my C is 0, because my constructor is going to run. My constructor will be called automatically. What is going to happen? Like, my constructor is going to be called by its own. Once I create the object of my class, my constructor will be called automatically. When my constructor called you, it is going to initialize my ABC with 0 value. And when I call my getDisplay function, it will going to show me all the values. One more thing which I need to explain you guys, it is not compulsory. Like in constructor, you just can put your default value, but basically default constructor, we always put default value into the variables. Why we do so? Because data member, whenever we are using, we don't know whenever we are using, but the moment we are assigning them a memory, at the same time, it is very important to initialize with some default value so that none of the garbage value or any garbage value may not start existing there. Because once you have a garbage value into the same space, it may destroy your answer. Means whatever calculation, whatever you are going to do in that space, any garbage value can destroy your answer. So what is the best habit is, like, whenever you are creating a memory for your data member or for any variable, at the same time, we basically give some default value to it. If you don't have your own constructor, Java has its own constructor, automatic constructor, which runs each and every time. And while a memory is assigned, while any variable is getting a memory, at the same time, the memory will be initialized. The memory will be initialized with some default value so that it may not destroy anybody's answer due to the garbage value. That is the reason. It is a good habit. So, that is the reason, like, I have called get display and I have shown you the answer. But if you want, you can feed some default value also. For example, if I want to feed a default value for A, so I can write here 2, default value of B, I can write here 3, default value of C also I can write here. And once I compile, I run, I'll get to know the same value, means whatever value I'm giving to it, and it will be visible to me. You can see A is 2, B is 3, and C is 4. So basically, what is the meaning of this thing is A, B, and C, some default value is initialized and I can use it. In get display function, I can display, and even if I want to add all these values can be added, and one answer also it will be visible to you. Now I'm just going to add one more different type of constructor in the same, because we are going to apply all three different types of constructor. What I can do is, guys, you can design as many constructors as possible. We know the name of the class should be same, but how constructor will be differentiated, and how control will be able to know what is the difference in between the constructor with the help of this parenthesis. You can see with the help of its prototype, with the help of its signature, the control will be able to understand, okay, which constructor I need to call. So once again, I'm just going to write here cons. I'm opening here parenthesis, and this time I'm going to work on parameterized constructor. I'm using here LMN. And I'm using an LMN. And what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to give some value from my while I'm creating any object. I'll be creating any object of my class, at the same time I'm going to pass few values to the constructor, and the same values will be taken up and it will be given, or you can say the variables will be initialized with those values. So I'm just going to come up in this constructor. This is my parameterized constructor, and what I'm going to do is, I'm simply assigning this L to my A, I'm putting semicolon, and I'm assigning my M to this B, putting semicolon, and I'm assigning my N to this C, and I'm putting semicolon. So it is up to me, like, which constructor I need to call. Whenever I'm creating an object of my class, it is up to me, like, which constructor. For example, this is here I'm creating an object of my class, but the first constructor, default constructor, I don't need to call here. I just need to call here parameterized constructor. So in place of this blank or empty, you can see you can pass few values. So when your control check, okay, someone is passing 3 values into the constructor, so the same 3 values constructor will be called, and 2, 5, or 6, whatever value you are giving, it will be passed to LMN. From LMN, it will be given to ABC. And if you want, with the help of get display, you can check those things. I'm just going to click on compile, coming back to my main screen, and I'm going to run from here. Now, when you right click, you will get to know new cons, and I'm just going to click on OK, and you will be able to know this thing. Okay, it is 2, 3, and 4. The same thing what I have given, I'm just going to get the same thing. One more thing, while you're running your program, guys, this time you can see a little difference, like whatever constructors you have created, you can see those constructors also. But if you want to run your program, you need to click on void main. So once you click on void main, you will get to know the output screen, and whatever means whatever values you are giving in a parameterized constructor, with the help of get display, you will be able to see all those values. So in case of constructor, guys, while you right click to your class, you will be able to know like void main and the name of whatever constructor you have defined in it. So I've already explained you the use of constructor, why we use constructor, and this is the third constructor what I'm going to discuss in this session today, that is copy constructor. A little tricky but not difficult. So I'm just going to write here my copy constructor code. So what we do, like again, I'm just going to write here the name of my class, that is cons, and I'm just opening my brackets here. And in this constructor, I'm going to pass some object of my, one object of my class only I'm going to pass up here. So I simply write here cons, I write here obj. I come to my next class, sorry, I just come inside this body of constructor, and my code will be ready now. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to pass one ready-made object, means one object of my class I'm going to pass in this constructor. Basically, you can see the name of the class and the name of constructor always same, but in copy constructor I'm going to pass one object of my class only. So I'm just going to create one object, I'm going to fill with some value, and that object I'm going to pass up here because its name is copy constructor only. So that what you can do basically here, you can copy your one object into another object. This is overall, you know, the procedure, overall idea of using this this copy constructor. So I'm just adding here dobj means dummy object, I'm going to give it to you, and you are going to copy these values to some other object. So how to implement it, how to use it, first of all I'm going to explain you this thing. You can see my one object is already ready here, so I'm just giving a name to it, that is obj1. And I'm writing here also obj1. So this is my one obj1 is object. This is already ready. What I need to do, guys, I just need to create one more object. So I'm just writing here cons, and I'm writing here obj2, and I'm writing here new, and again I'm writing here con as cons. But what I want to do is in this obj2, I need to copy this obj1. So I simply come up here and I write here obj1, means I just need to copy my obj1 to obj2. So here I'm just going to copy my obj1 to obj2. I'm just going to copy here. So what is going to happen, like whenever I'm writing here cons obj2, so my object obj2 will be created. So what I'm doing here is cons obj2 I have already created. I'm just writing here new. I need to copy this obj1. So I simply come up here and I write here obj1. Means I just need to copy my obj1 to obj2. So here I'm just going to copy my obj1. To obj2, I'm just going to copy here. So what is going to happen, like whenever I'm writing here cons obj2, so my object obj2 will be created. So what I'm doing here is cons obj2 I have already created. I'm just writing here new, and I'm writing here cons. So that means I'm creating here obj2. Obj2 means a new object whose name is obj2. This I'm creating here of type cons, and this obj2 I'm initializing with this obj1. So obj1 is an object which is already created, which has 2, 5, and 6, which I'm going to copy in this obj2. So guys, when I'm writing here cons obj2 is equal to new cons obj1, that means object 1 I'm trying to copy in object 2. So once you write this line, actually your control is going to start searching with this, like is there is any constraint constructor who is accepting object. Oh yeah, there is a constructor because we have already defined a constructor who is accepting some object. So what is going to happen with this, like, you know, whatever object you are passing in this DOBJ, whatever data you have in this DOBJ, because you are basically giving OBJ 1 to this DOBJ, and DOBJ is going to pass all data from OBJ 1 to OBJ 2. So how we can do this thing, guys? So I'm just going to introduce here a new keyword, that is this. With the help of this, what I'm referring is, I'm referring this OBJ2 with the help of this, because I've already called a constructor that is CONS, and in CONS I am passing OBJ1, guys. So this you need to understand, that in CONS copy constructor, I'm not giving any identity of this OBJ2. I'm not giving any identity of this OBJ2. So how I can copy my OBJ1 stuff to this OBJ2? So in my copy constructor, I'm going to consider this OBJ2 with this keyword. So wherever I wanted to write OBJ2, I'll be writing there this. So that is the reason I'm just writing here this dot A, because you can see I'm having data member. I'm having data member A, B, and C. So whatever I'm having in one object A, B, C, I'm putting in other object A, B, C. And LMN is nothing but it's just my formal parameter. So I'm not going to write there LMN. I'm writing here L, B, and C. So I'm simply writing here this dot A is equal to D O B J dot A. So whatever I'm having in D O B J is basically a copy of OBJ1. So whatever I'm having in OBJ1A, that will be copied to OBJ2A. So in this way, your entire data will be copied from OBJ1 to OBJ2. So simply I'm just going to copy. I'm going to paste, and with this A, I'm going to make change. A will be my B. This another A will be again my B. This will be C. And here again, I'm going to come and I'm writing here C. So once you have copied like entirely OBJ1 to OBJ2, what you need to do here, you just need to call getDisplay function so that you can check, okay, whether the thing, whatever you are trying to copy and paste, it is done or not. So I simply come up here and I write here OBJ2.getDisplay. My getDisplay function will start getting work, and I'll get to know, okay, what value is done, what value is there in OBJ2. So basically with this line, what I'm doing, I'm just giving my OBJ1 to OBJ2. And once my object one is transferred completely to OBJ2, I'm just going to check with the help of getDisplay, okay, whether my data is copied properly or not, whether my data is copied properly or not. So with this line, what I'm basically doing is I'm just checking whether my OBJ2 is created or not. So I'm just going to click on compile, and I'm just leaving here a simple message so that a user will get to know, okay, this is OBJ2. So I'm just simply writing a system.out.println, and I'm writing here OBJ2, so you will get to know the OBJ2 status. I'm going to click here on compile. You can see it's done. I'm coming up to my home screen. I'm going to right click here. I'm clicking on voidman because I just want to run my entire program. And you will be able to see the BlueJ screen. This is my BlueJ screen. You can see, guys, this is my last output. I'm just going to clear it, and I'm going to run it again so that you will be able to see a latest output. I'm clicking on void main. It's all done. And this is the output screen. So this is my A2, B5, and C6. So this is my OBJ1, guys. I just inserted, I just called, you know, parameterized constructor. I displayed using getDisplay function. And this is my OBJ2. I copied my OBJ1 to OBJ2. It is copied successfully. You can see with the help of OBJ2, I called the getDisplay function, if you remember. So this is again A2, B5, and C6. So guys, it is all done. Constructor need a lot of practices. So whatever all three different types of constructor I have used in this code, I'll give you in description. But you need to practice. You need to understand first the basic use of constructor, why we use constructor. I've already explained you. Constructor basically, you know, when you're assigning some memory to some object, to its data member, like the object you always create of some of the class. So we have data member function. Definitely data member, we just need to give some space. So while we are giving space, we are initializing with some value so that no garbage value will exist there, and it is not going to destroy anybody's answer. So it is a good habit, it is an advantage in Java. Like if you are not calling your constructor, Java has its own constructor, it runs automatically. It is going to initialize your data, all your variables, you know, with its default value. Like integer is always zero, decimal is 0.0, like that is float, and a double is 0.0, long is again zero, string is space, character is space, and boolean is false. So basically, you know, what we have done in this session, I've explained you all three different types of constructor. So whatever constructor you want to call, like default, if you want to give values, you can call parameterized constructor. And most of the time, we just need to copy one constructor to another constructor. That is again possible with the help of copy constructor. So please, guys, practice this code. So many times, think different ideas and try to design a program. And we'll be meeting in our next class with a new topic and new examples. Thank you.